Hey guys, this is Dustin from D3 Imagery. In tonight's video, we're going to be talking about how to get started post-processing light-painted astrophotography photos. There's a number of reasons why you might want to get into this. When you're shooting at night, you're shooting at higher ISOs, but when we paint the foreground of our photos, it allows us to get a lot more detail in our foreground interests, and it also allows us to play with light. As photographers, that's really our primary tool. It's not our camera, it's not our lenses, but it's our ability to hone and shape and creatively control light. And light painting is really kind of the epitome of that. So we're gonna go ahead and jump into Lightroom here. We're gonna take a look at just how that's done. This is gonna be just a really quick overview because I know you got other stuff going on in your life. On the left, we have our star shot. This is done on the 16 millimeter f1.4 on the Sony a6300. On our star shot, we were shooting at an ISO of 2000, and f1.4 was the aperture with a 20-second exposure, which is kind of the maximum for this lens. Our foreground shot was done at an ISO of 400, so a lot more detail in the shot, a lot less noise. Exposure time was 15 seconds, and it was shot at f4, which again kind of lends itself to being a little bit sharper of a photo as well. The whole idea behind light painting is that we should be able to do that. Another tool that was used in this shot was a 700 lumen flashlight, which I picked up that night and waved around like a madman in order to expose this. Now, when you go out and you shoot, you're going to probably take a lot of different exposures of the light painted frame, and I highly recommend that because you might want to try it from different angles. Or take a few different exposures, kind of playing around with the f-stop or the ISO values, and see what the best outcome is and go with it. So this was my best outcome. On the right, we have our light painted frame. So to get started, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna jump in here and I'm gonna adjust some things. I'm going to adjust a little bit of white balance, our shadows and highlights, black point, white point, all of that stuff. And then come back at the end. We're gonna speed it up so that you don't have to sit through every single little change that I make. So here we go. All right, so I'm going to pause real quick and mention this. When we combine these two photos, the method that we're going to use, what it's looking for are the brightest pixels. So essentially, whatever's the brightest pixel in either one of the shots is going to be the pixel that's used. So what we want to do here is we want to avoid the sky in this image, which does have the faint hint of a few stars here and there. We want to avoid those stars from accidentally showing up in the main exposure. So something I'm going to do real quick as I process this photo in Lightroom is take the adjustment brush and kind of brush out the exposure of those wayward stars and make sure that they don't end up in the final exposure as we combine these images. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now as well. Okay, so I think that looks pretty good. Our light painted frame, I like where we're starting with the exposure here. I like where we're starting with just the overall look of it, and I feel the same way about the star shot as well. Now we're going to take these two photos, we're going to bring them into Photoshop as layers, and that's where we're going to do a little bit of final touch-up and magic to the images. So to do that, we're going to highlight both of these images, and we're going to go up to the photo menu, on Mac at least, and we're going to go to edit in, and then we want to click on open as layers in Photoshop is our next step. Okay, so here's where a little bit of the magic happens, or at least where it begins. Now, as I mentioned before, the way we merge these photos together, we're going to do it in such a way that Photoshop is going to take the lightest pixel and it's going to use that as the pixel that is revealed in the merged photo. Very simple way of doing that is we're going to have the star frame selected, and we're going to drop down this menu in the layers, and we're going to select the lighten option. And this is where things start to get a little exciting, because we can start to see the photo come together. And one of my favorite parts, I'm going to do this a couple more times too, is when you turn this layer on and off. It's just really fun, because it's kind of like turning the lights on and off. You really start to see things come together. But you're going to notice that because the star frame still has some parts of the shot that may not be desirable, such as this overexposed hill or the overexposed dam over here on the left side, that we're going to want to do a little bit of work to cut that stuff out. Now in this photo, I mean, every photo is going to be different, but in this one, something that I really like about it, an element to it that I really like, is when this long exposure was being captured, there are a few lights that are inside of this building and some reflections on the window that I actually kind of value and I think I'd like to keep in the final shot. So I'm going to work around those as well as I kind of tighten up this exposure the way that I like it. Okay, so at this stage, what I've done is we're about to remove some of the overexposed parts of the shot, which are interfering in our final shot. But as I mentioned before, I want to keep the windows there, the reflections and the lights that are emitting from inside of this dam, this building. And also there's a couple of lights in the foreground I may or may not decide to keep, but I'm going to go ahead and keep them for now and see how the combined exposure looks. So we've removed those from being selected here as we go ahead and remove the undesirable overexposed parts of the shot. So we're going to go ahead and click delete. We're going to remove these parts of the shot, and then we're going to add our foreground back in. And as we can see here, things have started to take shape, and we see the lights being turned on and off again. And I'm really liking this. I think the only other thing I'm seeing so far that I want to adjust is this chimney thing is a little overexposed. So we're going to want to work with that. And this hill over here is kind of green. This is snow, so it should be white. So we're going to make some adjustments to that. So I'm going to go ahead and fast forward through that real quick, and you can watch how I do this. Yeah, this chimney will need a little bit of work when we finally merge the image together, but we went ahead and removed that overexposed part that I wasn't too fond of. Another way that you can go about doing this is in the layers panel. If we add a layer mask and then we press B for a brush, we can also brush out parts that we don't want, or we can adjust the opacity of the parts that we may want to remove just a little bit of. So, you know, for instance, this little bit of light over here, I might want to bring the exposure of this bit of light down so that it's not capturing your eye too much. So I can do that way. So far I'm really happy with the way this is looking. I'd like to go ahead and something that I'd like to do personally is take each of these layers and just do a final bit of touch up to them, or a final bit of adjustment to them in Camera Raw, and make things pop out a little bit more even. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so there we go. Just a little bit of adjustment. I noticed the clarity in Camera Raw. To me, at least, it just seems to kind of pop things out even more so than clarity in Lightroom. Maybe you've had that experience too. Maybe I'm just crazy, but I just like what it did. So don't fault me for that, hopefully. So I'm really happy with where this is going. So there are just two more things that I want to do to this. First of all, I want to fix that. I'm going to combine the image now. Before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and just duplicate these layers, because we don't want anything to be final until it's final. And we're going to go ahead and just turn off the duplicated layers, or the original ones. We're going to merge these layers into one and do a few final edits, which I hope you'll enjoy. Okay, now that I fixed up a couple of minor things. What I like to do before I ship it is I like to also add the selective color layer and do a few just to my eye modifications to color, really light, you know, changes to color that I personally like to see. So that's what I'm going to do next. Okay, so this is it. I usually try to be pretty light on the selective color because you can go really crazy with it and come out with something that looks like it's wildly color graded or something. So really pleased with the image. Now you do notice that in the top corners, it looks like the vignetting still had, even with the profile corrections, a little bit of an effect on the final image, which is why Instagram has the crop factor, right? So, you know, what I would probably do before posting this is, you know, just do a 4x5 fixed ratio crop. And that would probably end up being my final image. But of course, I won't destroy the image. I would probably just copy merged. Wouldn't destroy it by, you know, just flattening it right now, but I would open a new document altogether. And here is our final image. So there you go. I hope that the guide was a help, quick start on how you can light paint and combine, you know, a light painted exposure and a star exposure such as this. It's not too difficult. And again, I hope that this guide has piqued your interest in giving this a try yourself if you haven't. And you may be a pro at this and you've done this many times and you have some suggestions or tips or hints that you can add to the conversation in the comments section below. I'd be really welcome to you adding your piece of insight as well to the conversation. So again, this is Dustin from D3 Imagery. I hope you enjoyed the guide. I hope it inspires you to get out there and shoot something awesome. Thank you for subscribing and for liking this video, and I wish you a great rest of your day. Thanks again for watching.